I welcome you to this lesson. I'm teacher Katimbo Richard, teaching mathematics. Today I've come with a summary of a topic called algebra. And when you watch this episode, you will then be able to answer the activities from page 65 all the way to 71 of term 3 workbook. And now I urge you to follow. You will then have that clear picture of what algebra is all about. And these, remember, are examples which, when followed, you will answer the activities for the same pages, that is from page 65 all the way to 71 of our workbook. And here we go. Example number one. Find the missing number in each of these four. Action five. Examples here involving addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division of numbers. So we've got a box. So box plus 7 is equal to 20. So in other words, what must 7 be added to get 20? So we said in algebra, when you are given an operation, you do the opposite of that given operation in order to find the unknown. You must note that the opposite of addition operation is subtraction operation. An opposite of subtraction is, of course, addition. Then the opposite of multiplication operation is division. And so the opposite being true, that is, the opposite of division is multiplication. So when you are told to solve or find the unknown in an equation like this one, you look out for the operation brought by the examiner. The examiner has brought a plus sign of addition. So do you subtract to solve the problem? So that's why I've got box plus 7 minus 7 equals that 20 we found this side minus 7. You know 7 minus 7 is a 0. So this being a 0, forget it, and have a box remaining this side. And now we know 20 minus 7 is a 13. So the content of the box is a 13. So box is a container, then the content is a 13. So we fill it in the original box and see if when added we get that 20. So that is 13 plus 7. Good. The 20. So therefore, this is the real and only content of that box. So then we go to part B, where the box is in the middle. 3 plus a box equals 8. 3 plus a box equals 8. In other words, what must be added to 3 to get 8? So now, what a plus. So it means we're going to subtract 3 from both sides. 3 minus 3 plus box equals 8 minus 3. And see, 3 minus 3 is a 0, forget it. So here, I've got a box remaining. So 8 minus 3 is equal to 5. So box contains 5. Let us see whether when we fill it in here, we get the correct answer. 3 plus 5. Okay, get 8. So therefore, this box indeed contains that 5. As you look at example number part C. Part C, find a missing number, fill it in. Box minus 2 equals 7. This time round, we've got a minus. We say the opposite of a plus is a minus, and therefore the opposite of a minus is a plus. So we go then, we are going to add 2 to both sides. We say box minus 2 plus 2 equals 7 plus 2. So what you do this side is what you do the other side. If you chose to subtract, also subtract. We have chosen to add, please add. So we must note that minus 2 plus 2
is the same as plus 2 minus 2. So to understand it better, we start with the plus and interchange this statement from minus 2 plus 2 to plus 2 minus 2. So I've got box plus 2 minus 2 equals the sum here of 7 and 2. 7 plus 2 get 9. So I've got box plus 2 minus 2 equals 9. So then 2 minus 2 I have 0. So this one goes away. Memory box. So box contains 9. Let's see if it makes sense if written here. So 9 minus 2. Not answering. 9 minus 2. Good. It's a 7. So therefore, this content of this box is only 9. When you fill in any other, you will not get a correct answer. Then look at the multiplication road. Find if what is contained in the box, given that 5 times box is equal to 35. So this is times, meaning we only find what is contained in this box, but in the opposite of multiplication, which is a division. But let us first simplify. 5 times box, you get 5 box. So 5 box equals 35. Now, the next step, we are going to divide by 5. So whenever we say out of, we are dividing. So 5 box divided by 5 equals 35 divided by 5. So we go 5 divided by 5 once. 5 box divided by 5, you get a box remaining here. For 5 has gone, then 5 divided by 5 is a 1. 35 divided by 5, you get a 7. So box contains 7. And then come and fit in this original box and see 5 times 7. This 35 ready? Good. Therefore, the box contains only 7. And that is the answer. Then let's look at the fourth operation when the examiner has chosen to bring that. Box divided by 3 is equal to 5. Box divided by 3 is equal to 5. I say it here. Whenever you see the word divide by, it's the same as out of. So box divided by 3 is the same as box out of 3. So box out of 3 equals 5. So these two mean the same. And when you have brought a division, you multiply. So we are multiplying both sides by 3. You say 3 times box out of 3 equals 3 times 5, this side also. And now when you are effecting the cancellation, you cancel this side before reaching the equal side. So we go by 3 once. 3 by 3 once. So remain the box here. So I've got box equals 3 times 5. With 3 times 5 is 15. So the box contains 15. So let us put that content here in the box. So write up 15 there. Is 15 when divided by 3 equal to the 5? Check. 15 divided by 3. You are not calculating. I'm seeing you. Please. 15 divided by 3. Check. I'm waiting for you. Good. It's 5. So indeed, this box contains 15 and nothing else. Now, that's about the four operations and how one can fill the box or find the unknown using the given operation. As we look at example number 2. Example number 2 is in word form. Never fear to read. Please always read. Let's read together. When 12 is added to a number, the result is 29. Just hear that. When 12 is added to a number, the result is 29. Then the question is, what is the number? So instead of bringing a number like this one, they bring it in one form. So here, instead of the box, we are going to use a letter. You say, let the number be Y. Let the number be Y. Actually, we have brought something like number 1. 12 is added to a number. So let the number be Y. We say Y plus 12 is equal to 29. Meaning 12 has been added to a number Y. Meaning a number we don't know. So the result means the outcome, so which is equal to 29. The result is represented by the equal sign here. So equals 29. So what the equation that we have formed to find the unknown. So instead of the box, we've got a letter now. Y plus 12 is equal to 29 now. So we've got a plus, then we are going to subtract 12 from both sides. Indeed, in the first example here, we say y plus 12 minus 12 equals 29 minus 12. You know, 12 minus 12 is a 0, so it goes away and then the y. And now put a sign back here to subtract. Excuse me. Minus 12. Minus 12. You subtract properly and then you see how you go about this. So we've got 9 minus 2 is a 7. Then we've got 2 minus 1 is a 1. So y equals a 17. Meaning the place of y, we can think about 17. So now 17 plus 12, you add and see. If you get 29, then the answer is correct. So we say the number 4. 17 is the number. That's how we find the unknown given a number that contains words. So then go to number 3. Example number 3 reads, when 3 is subtracted from a number, the answer is 7. Find the number. When 3 is subtracted from a number, okay, the answer is 7. Find the number. Oh, so it's the same as this now. 2 is subtracted from a number, we don't know. The result is 7. Here, we've got 3 is subtracted from a number. You still say, let the number be a letter of your own wish. Brought in M. So, 3 subtracted from M. So that means M minus 3, the result is 7. So equals 7. So the equation we have is M minus 3 is equal to 7. And then we introduce the plus sign of addition to solve the problem of minus 3. We say M minus 3 plus 3 equals 7 plus 3. And then order. I say minus 3 plus 3 is the same as plus 3 minus 3. To understand better, write the other way around, starting with a plus. That's M plus 3 minus 3 equals this 7 plus 3, which is the 10. And now, this is a 0, 3 minus 3 is a 0, it goes away. Remain with M, so M is equal to 10. Let's see whether in place of M, we can write a 10 and see whether the statement remains correct. 10 minus 3, 7. So therefore, 10 is the number. 10 is the number. So 3 is subtracted from 10 and the result is 7. So the number is indeed 10 and none other than that very one. And which one done that, my before member will jubilate, will be happy like you are now. As we look at example number 4, which reads, when a number is multiplied by 2, the result is 8. Find the number. Still say, let the number be a letter, which is n now. So, a number n is multiplied by 2. That's n times 2. The result is 8, equals 8. Thereby having an equation that reads n times 2 is equal to 8. Like we did here, we had 5 times box and we got 5 box. Like here, n times 2 get 2n. So 2n is equal to 8. So we divide both sides by 2. That's 2n divided by 2 equals 8 divided by 2. Cancel by division. By 2 once. 2n divided by 2, you get n remaining. So 2 divided by 2 once. 8 divided by 2, you get 4. N is equal to 4. So n is equal to 4. So let's see. If we replace or substitute n with this 4, we get the answer. 4 times 2. 4 times 2. Tell me the answer. 2, 4 times 2? Must be known in table 2. 4 times 2? Good, 8. So therefore, when a number we don't know now, we know 4 is multiplied by 2, you get 8. So therefore, this is the therefore symbol. You say therefore, three signs that are shaped, or three dots shaped like a triangle. So we say therefore, 4 is the number. As we look at the last example here, three is when Tom divides the number by 3, he gets 12 as the answer. Find the number. When Tom divides the number by 3, he gets 12 as the answer. Find the number. You still say, I don't know the number. Let me suggest a letter. You say, let the number be P. So when the number P is divided by 3, when Tom divides a number by 3, a number P is divided by 3, the answer is 12. So that's P divided by 3 is equal to 12. Find the value of P. Find the number P. Remember, P divided by 3 is the same as P out of 3. So now P out of 3 is equal to 12. Now we are going to multiply both sides by 3. You say 3 times P out of 3 equals 3 times 12. So let's have our side work. Sometimes you can call it part of work. Underline here and get our 12 times 3 to see the outcome. 3 times 2. Thank you, Mary. It's a 6. Then 3 times 1. Oh, Jane. So that is a 3. So 12 times 3 is 36. And therefore, P, after this cancellation, by 3 ones, make P. So P is equal to 36. And therefore, 36 is the number. That's how we do all the things. So when a number 36 is divided by 3, you get 12. So therefore, actually 36 is the only number that suits this very statement. And that's the way we summarize, or we do work out those numbers in algebra. Remember, this is episode number 1. That's why we say algebra summary 1. We've got a second summary that comes after this one. Please first internalize this one. Answer those activities on the same pages of 65 all the way to 71. Then teacher will come to the second episode of this algebra, and still in terms of summary for the discussion in terms of notes was done long ago. So within this term, that is term 3, we can call that a lesson. We meet in the next episode. I am teacher Katimbo Richard. For clarity or more clarification or more explanation, you can reach me on these two numbers you see here, 0776251655. All use this one down here, 07572330 66, in case you need more clarity or explanation. That is the end of this lesson, and remember to join us in the next episode or so. Please stay safe and bye bye.